Hello and welcome to this video, Gareth here from tastytutes.com. In the last video, I discussed what a scamp is, and we saw some examples of how designers may think and develop a design idea before jumping straight onto the computer. In this video, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate the design process I undertook to come up with the design for the finished business card, letterhead, and brochure. Along the way, I will be referring to the finished design so you can see how the process developed into the finished design. Now, in this video, I'll be showing you some of the ideas I had, but I also encourage you to think about your own ideas, which you can develop later in the course as we begin to create the design in Adobe InDesign.
Now, if you open the project folder, open the design process folder, then open design sheets. In there, you will be able to get access to design sheets for the business card, letterhead, and brochure. Now, these are simple blank sheets which you can print off and use as quick template guides to draw inside to think about your ideas. I used these to come up with my design, which you will see shortly. If you want to get the design sheets, you will need to download the project folder. Link is in the description. Okay, so let's first take a quick look at the finished document we are going to create later on in this course. So I'm going to open the project folder again, open the finished examples folder, come into the ID work docs, select all the InDesign files and open with InDesign. If you wish to take a closer look at these, you can find them in the project folder, link is in the description. So starting with the business card, here we have the cover and a very particular style here on the back. Next, we have the letterhead. We have the typesetting on one side and the motif on the back. And finally, we have the brochure. As I scroll down, we can see the various layouts. So how did I get all of this and decide on all the compositions? So let's take a look now at the design process. So I'm going to open the project folder again, come down to the design process folder and open the design process PDF. If you wish to follow along and open this document, you can download the project folder, link is in the description. So this is the design process document. So with your document open, let's begin. So on page one is the brand guidelines. This is where the main source of inspiration will come from and some of the boundaries I will have to work within. Here we can see how the logo works on the dark grey and white background. We have the brand colours below and the brand shape and pattern to keep in mind. So let's take a look at the process for the business card. So for this, I simply sketched out a couple of possibilities. Really simple sketches. This took me about 10 minutes to draw out. Just visualising some initial thoughts I had in mind, just to see what they might look like. On the top, here I considered having the logo simply on the grey background or perhaps having blocks of colour around the outside. Below are a couple of layout ideas I had in mind. Here I have explored some simple approaches of maybe having just nice clean type aligned centre. Since the logo has nice thin strokes, perhaps I could use this in a minimal way. Here I have thought perhaps working some strokes around the type to bring a little colour in. Then perhaps place the pattern inside of one of the bottom zones. Same again below, though with an alternative layout. Over on the left, perhaps instead of strokes, I could just use some solid blocks of colour. So how did I develop this afterwards? So if I jump into InDesign to look at the finished design, if we start with the cover, we can see that for this, I chose to keep the front simple and let the logo have a bold presence set on the dark grey background. So jumping back to the scamp, I chose to go with my first idea, which was to keep it simple. So back in InDesign, if we turn to the back, here we can see that the idea I chose here was the one with the subtle strokes on the right, the typesetting here on the left, and placing the pattern in this area here where the two strokes connect. For this design, I also chose to keep the background dark grey, like on the front. So jumping back to the process doc, you can see where the idea came from. So next, let's take a look at the letterhead. Well, same again. Here are a quick ideas I had in mind. On the top, are a few ideas of the typesetting of how the logo would be positioned on the page. I also thought of including some strokes of colour, like on the business card, or some solid blocks of colour at the bottom. Below are some ideas of the back of the letterhead, again using coloured strokes, solid colour blocks, or incorporating the pattern. So how did I develop this? Well, if we jump into InDesign to look at the finished letterhead design, here we can see that I chose to use the idea with the logo on the left, with the solid colour blocks at the bottom. I think this looks quite nice in InDesign. Now, if I press W to activate normal mode in InDesign, we can see here the grid that the typesetting fits nicely to. We have this nice negative space here on the left, room for each design element to breathe, and a nice touch of brand color at the bottom here. Now, if we take a look at the back of the letterhead, here we can see that we have a combination of strokes, solid color, and the pattern creating the brand style on the page. Looking at the earlier sketches, we can see here where the inspiration came from. So next, let's take a look at the ideas behind the brochure. So here I was thinking about how the cover and back could work as a single composition. Here I explored three ideas. The logo in the center of the cover with the color boxes spreading across the front and back page. Next, a bit more abstract, perhaps having the logo across the fold. And lastly, having the logo set in white with color and strokes around. Now, sometimes if I like an idea, I'll draw it again to refine it further. So on this occasion, we have the idea I wanted to go with. Here we have the logo placed in the center of the cover on the right, and blocks of color in various opacities would overlay and spread across the front and back page. Now you may be wondering, why is the cover set on the right and not on the left? Well, here I am drawing the sketch how it would be laid out in InDesign, how it will effectively be printed. When this document is printed, the back and front will be printed on a single sheet of paper and folded and stapled down the middle to join the other printed spreads. As this is the front and back, this is how it will wrap around the outside of the document. So how did I develop this afterwards? So if we jump into InDesign to take a look at the cover of the brochure, here we can see how the sketch idea has transpired into the finished idea. So, like the business card, here I am keeping the background dark grey with the transparent colours overlapping like so. Now, if I press W to activate normal mode, we can see how the colours spread across as planned in the sketch. Now, if I just jump to the back page of the brochure, we can see, just like in the sketch, we have the logo and colours overlapping. So this has been set up, so once printed, will be a seamless design across the front and back, just like in the sketch. So next you can see some ideas I had for some spreads inside the brochure. This is an example of very quick, fast and creative ideas. Here I covered a lot of ground and got a lot of ideas out of my mind fast to explore and decide whether to take any forward or not. So the idea here was to think of a variety of possible compositions. All these white areas with crosses in them represent image crops. Here I am imagining how images may be contained in shapes, cropped by blocks of colour, and how the type would work around them. I like the idea of using lots of diagonal lines to reflect the nature of the logo. So after that, I chose to redraw and develop a couple of ideas from the previous ideas. Here, I'm thinking how colour may be incorporated into the spreads, and how images could be placed inside shapes similar to the logo. So here is an example of how an idea developed. So on the far left was the first quick idea sketched out. I liked the idea of an image in a hexagon, but thought perhaps might be more impactful as a single element. So next, I refined this a little and thought perhaps how colour could work around the image with some strokes. Finally, I could see how this would work and developed it further to include the pattern into the top left side. So here is the decisive scamp of this spread. So let's take a look how I implemented this in InDesign. So back in InDesign, here is the opening spread using that sketch as a reference. Here we have the hexagon image in the center across the fold, the color and the strokes and the pattern in the top left. Again for this, I chose to keep the background dark gray and we have some type with the colors. Now the image in the hexagon has been developed further. Upon further development of the brochure in InDesign, I decided to give each image a monochrome effect to sit nicely with the colors. So with all the ideas I initially sketched, it was this spread which defined the overall style that would carry on throughout the brochure, such as on the next spread. Here we have a specific image color treatment on the images and stroke and color applied to the layout with the pattern on the top. If we jump back into the scamp, we can see that this was developed from one of the earlier sketches. Looking at the next spread, we have this triangle composition. This was also developed from one of the sketches here. So with the next spread, I chose to imitate a previous one but used the blue. And on the final spread, I used an alternative layout developed from one of the sketch ideas I had previously.
So that's how I sketched out my initial thoughts, took a couple of rough ideas and developed them on the computer to finished compositions. So how would you design the business card? How would you design the letterhead? And how would you design the brochure? Later on in this course, I'll be showing you exactly how to take your ideas from a sketch and implement them in Adobe InDesign just like I did. But before that, I would encourage you to have a go at thinking about your own ideas.
As suggested earlier, with the project folder open, open the design process folder, and in there you will be able to get access to the design sheets for the business card, letterhead and brochure. With these, you can print them off and have a go at sketching out some of your design ideas.
So if you're up for the challenge, have a go at drawing some of your ideas and take reference from my design process. Then, once you are happy, continue watching this course and try and implement your design later. If you do this, I guarantee you will learn more and get more out of this course. So that's how I developed my ideas for my print design. So now I'm ready to take the ideas off the page and develop them on the computer. But what programs do I use? In the next video, I'm going to discuss the right software to use for print design. See you in the next video.